Well, electricity is back, and I'm back. Before we were interrupted by electricity, I was trying to refactor this code so that it can be as general as possible, so that we can be able to scrap all the links from Wikipedia. And I think we had reached somewhere where I was creating a function. So I'm going to define a function, and I'm going to call it scrap or scrape, I don't know how you pronounce this, scrap wiki, and it should take a URL. So we need this part here, and then I need this part to be in the function. We need this part. So if you have not watched the previous video, the link is in the description. You better go and watch that so that you can be able to follow this part easily. Just as a recap, we are trying to get all links from Wikipedia starting from one page, and using the law of 6 degrees of separation, I think we can be able to get all the links in 6 levels. You'll see that in the future, in this video, as we continue working on this. And so far, we have been able to get data from one page, get links from one page, and create a data frame, this one. So what we want to do now is to be able to write a function that calls itself. It's called a recursive function, to be able to get all the links for all the pages that we may be able to reach. So I've reached here. This is the body content. We need this. So this was the function that I was trying to, this was the part that I was trying to do, to use least comprehension. But I think least comprehension is, it is faster, but in our case we may want our code to be fast. The good thing, we understand this part of the code. Let me just transform it so that we can be able to make this fast. I'm going to get this part here, and I put it here. Then I say for link in this, for link in this. So I'm just trying to rewrite this this as least comprehension. So for link in that, then I say if this, so we have, so this part of code here is the same as this, but this one takes longer to run, then this one takes shorter time to run. So I'm going to drop this, and I remain with this. This is URL, which will be passed here, and then we create this. Yep, so these are all links. We have all links here, then we create a data frame. So all links, I want all links to be a variable that is a universal variable. So I'm going to call it all links, should be that. Then I say all links is a list plus that list, so we have something like this. Command Z. I don't know what's happening. think one of my keys is downshift here. Command Z, Z, Z. So this. Okay, so all links should be inside the function. All links is the list, and this is the list that I'll be updating, and then this is the function that will be calling me, passing the URL. So we don't need this part, we have already used it. We don't need this, we don't need this, we don't need this. Then after that, we create a data frame using all links. I just want to see that this will work. Let me get a Wikipedia link, then have lots of things opened. I'm going to call this function. So my URL now, let's just put URL now is this. Then I'm going to call this function. Then when I call this function, I'm going to pass URL. This is not defined, so I run this. All links, perhaps we forgot a comma, there should be a plus here. Okay, that is there, so let's see, what's the error? We used all links before assignment. Okay, so what does this mean? Should I make it a class? I don't know if I should make it a class. I doubt if I need it to be a class. But I think making it a class would be much better. So let's just define a class and we call it wiki. Wiki script. So this is a function inside that class, and then I'm going to define a constructor. And I pass in self. Then inside the constructor, I'm going to call all links. So self dot all links should be an empty that. Then this this takes in self and URL. Yep. Then what we need is to update this, so we're going to say self dot all links. We don't need this anymore, so self dot all links. Then it's going to be this. Yep, I hope it is visible. Then, so now that we have all links here, we are going to call this function inside here, and we pass all links. Yeah, but before that, I want to be able to access these all links and make a data frame. So I'm going to run this, then I'm going to create an object here. Let me just call it object. Object will be wiki scrap. Then when we have object as wiki scrap, I'm going to say this object should object dot scrape, and what I'm scraping is going to be this URL. Okay, so I'm going to run this. An error text that was given to. No, it should be object is wiki scrape. Yeah, sorry. It should be object. This URL should be here. Sorry about this. I don't need this space, and then this URL should be here. Run. So it has finished. So I can do object dot. So if I want to get all links, is here. I hope I can be able to get all of them. It has nothing. So where did we go wrong? Let's try again. Object, wiki script, nothing. Where did I go wrong? Can we print this? Just trying to log this and see what's happening here. Just going to give this a variable name, and then I try to print it here just to make sure that that's not the part of the code that is bringing us problems. So run this, run that, run this. So it did not print this script wiki. Are we able to access this? Print accessed. Are we able to access it? Yeah, so we can print accessed. Okay, and this is not giving us anything. I think maybe the error is coming from here. I'm going to first of all remove this part just to be sure that that is not where the error is coming from. I run this. No. Control Z. Control Z. Okay. So I don't know what I'm doing wrong. I need to, so since we're accessing this, do we know what the URL is? Let's try to print the URL. We are back to debugging. I've done lots of things here. The URL is fine, so that means that we can access this data. So this is the problem. Let me see if we can get this body content from here. Yeah, we can get the body content. So the problem is here. The problem is here. Let's go slowly. Let's start with this. So we print that MKK. Okay, so we can print MKK. Command Z. So the if I want to see what happens here. So it is slash wiki 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This one exists. Oh, we don't have link. Our link is here. I don't know where the problem is coming from, and it is wasting our time. I think, can we try without this? This. Oh, okay. Okay, I don't need this. Unhashable stuff dot attribute is unhashable. So we are going to, instead of using the list comprehension, I'm going to use the for loop. I hope I can go back to history and do that. I hope I still have that history here. Sorry about this. We are still going to use a class. I just want to get back to the loop. Yep. And this is the loop. So I am not going to use this. I don't know what's happening, but you can tell me in the description, in the comments below, what I was doing wrong. But for now, I just want it to work before I go on with it. Also, I want it to be a class. I've just realized that a class is better. So wiki. Okay, script, and our constructor is going to be take on self, and then we're going to have self dot all links should be that. Then this will be self. So this is a function that is inside that class. It also takes self as an argument. Then this will be self dot that. So this is fine. I hope this is fine. We can try it out. So I'm going to run this. Then I'm going to say my object is going to be equal to wiki script. Then we're going to say object dot script wiki takes in this link, then we're going to say pd dot data frame. We take that object dot all links. So hopefully this will work. Voila. So this is fine. I don't know why the list comprehension didn't work for the loop, but I am not God. I don't know everything. You can tell me why it failed, but also I'll be looking at it in the future. For now, we need to continue updating these links with the next URL. So we are going to, for each of the links here, I want to call this function. So I'm going to define a temporary holder for links that will be passed to the next step. So like a temporary links. So this will be like all links that we have been able to scrap from the whole server, but the temporary holder of links will be containing the links in a particular page. So the temporary link will be an empty list, and I'm also going to be appending the temporary link here so that we can be able to use the temporary link to pass into to do a recursive kind of thing to all the links in the temporary links, instead of again going to all the links here. So we could just use the links here every time we call the function again. So temporary link dot append this. So this is repeating. I'm just going to call it. Let me call this temporary link list. And then this is temporary link. And the temporary link is this one. Then this is here. So we are going to append it there and append it here. So when we are out of the loop, we can again call this function self dot. So this function is going to call itself, and we are going to pass the temporary link. But remember, the temporary link list, sorry, this should be a temporary link list. So the temporary link list is a list of links. So it's a loop. So I'm going to say for URL in this, I'm going to pass in that. Yeah, so I don't know what else is remaining. We don't need self here. We need to have the maximum number of steps that we can allow, because that we can allow this recursiveness. Like, how deep can we go into these pages? By deep, I mean that when we are here, I can go to this place, to this page, that is step one. Then I can go to this page, that is step two. So how deep will I continue going into these pages until I stop? Remember that according to the theory, the graph theory, there's at some point we start looping back into this page. So I think the maximum number of steps should be like 100. That will be so big. I think we should go up to 20. So I'm going to define, so wiki scrape, and then it should take also step. Then here we are going to do step equals to step plus one. Sorry. Then it takes in a URL and it takes in step, but we need it to continue going deeper if step is less than or equal to n. So let's just say 20 here, because we want it to be 20 steps deep. Then we can continue if it is less, but if it is not, we can break out of the recursiveness. So we have this, it takes in URL and step. Yep, I think we are good to go. So this takes in URL and we start with the first step. I would like not to go up to 20 for testing. Let me just go to steps. I run that. Two steps will take long, because for each of the URLs that it gets in the page, it has to go to the next step. So this is going to take a long period of time. And if we are saying that the degree of separation for most of pages or any network is majorly 6 for more so a social network, we are going to talk about this in the next video. Then we expect, remember that like there are 7 billion people in the world, I think more than 7 billion. And if the degree of separation between me and Obama is 6, that means that the quantity of data that I'm going to be picking to scrape people is a lot. And I know that the number of pages in Wikipedia is a lot, close to the number of people. So if the degree of separation is also 6, that means that to go to the second degree of separation, in fact, instead of calling this step, I should call it degree. So if the degree is 2, that means that we are going to do a lot. Hopefully we can be able to get this. So I'm going to pause this video now until this completes. Then if it has an error or if it completes, then we shall continue. So it did complete. I had to stop it and kind of change things around. The less than or equal sign thing was not working here, so I've made it less than 4. I've put the degree here so that it increments after it runs, and I'm also logging the degree and the number of links in that link list. I don't need this. I don't need this. I don't need these ones. I don't need this. They're now all refactored inside this class. I'm going to restart the kernel, and then I'm going to run all cells. Hopefully it will start printing out this. Yeah, so I'll be back when it completes now. I had to spend a lot of time waiting for this to complete, and again I altered the code. So the degree is here, printing the degree here. Went 4 steps, but I was limiting the list to pick only 3 links because it was taking long and I need to end this video. So after running this, we have this as our data frame. This is the output. This is the source, this is the destination. Yeah, so what I'm going to do next, before the next video, will be more of web scraping, not web scraping, I mean more of network science and maybe some bit of graph theory. And by then I will need a pair of source and destination to create nodes for the graphs. So for before then, I'll work with the degree. I think I'll run up to 10. No, I'll run up to 15, and I will not limit this to any number of links, and I'll just leave it to run freely. I don't know how many days it will take to complete. Yeah, so this is the code that we have developed, and it is the one that will help us to scrape Wikipedia. You can find it in the link below. You'll find the link to GitHub. Until next week when we do graph theory, have a great week.